Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Fishing Planet. And in this video I'm going to do something totally new. So I'm going to start the competition, this competition, the Extravaganza competition in California. But I'm going to fish with topwater lures. I never did it. I never even fished with topwater lures, I think, on a sunny day. So I'm going to test it out, what I can achieve with the topwater lures. It's a little bit a guide too for the competition people that are interested in it, because of course I know what you need to do. I know the positions, I know the time frames. So what you need to do in this competition, it's going from 6 to 10 a.m. Between 6 and 7 a.m. it's a little bit dead. The only unique is the common carp, so you can go for the common carp from 7 to 8 to the trophy Chinook, and then from 8 to 10 you can go for the unique striped bass. That's what you need to do in this competition. So I'm going to start with this setup. So this is a setup. I'm only going to fish with this setup. So the RiverTech Zoys, it's the heaviest setup that you can have. 270, Thunderspin 5500, Fluoro 0.6 and the Walker 14G30. So that's what I'm going to do. So it's for me fun because I never did it before with this. So I'm not sure. Maybe I can, suck with this setup. I'm not sure. It's a possibility that I'm just ranked like 174th, because 174 people registered, because it's a very attractive competition. A lot of people like it because you can catch a lot of fish. The first guy you will see it is a possibility he's going to get over 200 kilograms. So what is this competition? Every fish above 5 kilogram is going to count. That's how it works. Simple, straight on. But now it's time to start fishing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to alternate. So here I come for the Chinook, because normally I fish here too with the bobber, but I'm not going to do that. So first of all, we are going to start in the foggy sanctuary. That's where we need to go to get some striped bass in. But now it's not so good, the time zone, because I still need to enter the competition. So let's enter the competition. And let's get going, guys. I hope that I can get fish, because I'm not sure it works really well. So most of the time I just start here. So I throw over there, because this is a very good striped bass spot. You can go a little bit to the right. You can go the dock at the right too. So let's have a look. The first guy already got one of 6 kilograms. So that's always a good start of that guy. So let's have a look. He's fishing for striped bass too. That's how you can see it. So most of the time you can see on the results, on the rankings, and that's already a fish, so that's not a bad start, but it's a smallmouth bass. So most at the time you can see on the rankings, those guys are fishing for striped bass too. So for the guys that are not very skilled in competitions, just go to the competition, just have a look, just check out what they are catching. And most of the time, you can see if you start at the beginning of a competition, you can see right away, oh, those guys are going for striped bass, because the steelhead is not as big as that. It is a possibility they got trophy common carp too, but I don't think so. They are going striped bass, and you can already see it in my chat too. So let's keep going for the striped bass. It's a possibility, yeah, and I think this is already a striped bass, so that's not bad. Very good start, and I'm sure this is a fish above 5 kilograms, and there you go, I'm already third, so that's not a bad start. So that's always good for the video, yeah, if I can catch fish, because I was a little bit worried that yeah, it's not going to work that well, this walker, because it's a very small walker, and I want to fish on very heavy fish, because the unique striped bass can go for to 20 kilograms. So this is what we are going to do the first hour. So, and then we are going to the Chinook spots, the two Chinook spots, to get a trophy. But it's already a good start. So yeah, that's two casts, and I got two fish. So not bad, not bad at all. Yeah, and I think the spot is already dead. So sometimes you can have that in this competition. So you are catching fish, and all of a sudden it's done. And the next 30 minutes you don't catch fish. On that moment you need to switch. But sometimes, even if you switch, because I know most of the spots, sometimes even if you switch, it's totally dead. I think that's the RNG in the competitions. Sometimes you cannot fix that problem. Therefore, the tournaments are a little bit better than the competitions. The longer the competition or tournament is, the more chance you have to do very good, because RNG is not that in there is a fish. Yeah, nice one. Oh, it's a fat one. Or, oh, no, it's a steelhead, I think. Yeah, and we are now in position number 10. And a 5.4. So that's a little bit RNG too, because the possibility was there that I got a fish under 5 kilograms. Steelheads, most of the time, they go under 5 kilograms. So that's not a bad start. So I'm at the moment number 12. So that's always good. But the thing is, it's unbelievable. Sometimes the amount. My best result in this competition was 119 kilograms in 1 hour in real life of fishing. But you need to have luck, because the thing is, it's 80%. No, that's not what I'm saying. So the thing is, it's a lot depends on what you know of the game. It's knowledge. But most of the guys that are fishing and fish a lot in competition, they got all the same knowledge. It's not that somebody else is doing something else. No, there is no secret. And then on that moment, it's purely RNG. So you already can see it. So I got a very good, I got a mediocre start, I call it. Because if I had a very good start, I had already now what the first guy had. 4 fish. He got 4, I got 2. Or 3. And there is, oh, I missed it. Ah, that's a pity. Because if that was 7 kilogram, I was top 3 already. Yeah, I need to focus, because I just lift my walker out of the water, and that's why I missed the bite, I think. So that's a pity, but yeah. And the thing is, in competitions, I see a lot of guys, I see that in the tournaments too, and I never understand that. I'm watching streams, and those guys, they are fishing, and they are not catching any fish. So what they start doing, they start changing lures. I never understood that. Because there is not one mechanic that is going to switch, you know. If a lure works, the lure works. So it's so strange, they don't catch anything. They just switch lure, they got a fish and they think, oh, we need to keep fishing with that. No, if you stay on the first lure, you're probably going to catch the same amount of fish. Oh, come on, fishy, come on. Come on, yeah, okay. Did you I lift it out of the water? And this is a small one. No, I'm lucky. Another 6.4. And I'm back in top 10. So still, what is it? 9 minutes to go. And then it's time to go to the Chinook. And you guys will see all those guys here that are playing the competition. They are going to do the same. All of a sudden, the striped bass in the chat is going to switch to the Chinook. Because you need to do that. Because it's not a unique striped bass zone, so and a Chinook can go to 20 kilograms too easy if you're very lucky. So therefore you need to switch, because normally in 1 hour, if you do it good, you can always get the trophy Chinook. Yeah, come on, fishy. Oh, he didn't bite through. But it's very active at the moment. So I was expecting a little bit less bites, but it goes really well, because I did sunny day competition between 5 and 6. That I didn't have 20 kilograms. So for me, a marker is the first hour 20 to 30 kilograms. If you want to go top 10, that's what you need. That's a good marker, the first hour. Then the next hour, some guys, the first one, most of the time got already 80 to 90 kilograms of fish. So after 2 hours, and then the unique striped bass hour still need to come. So, and you guys will see it on the rankings too. And I had a bite, and I need to say, those walkers, the attraction is very good. So I see potential. Maybe I can make a top 10, you never know. So, but it's still going well. I see a lot of fish still biting, because I already caught 4 or 5 fish, I think. So most of the time, that means time to switch spots. Because you can see it really well. Yeah, come on, fishy. Come on. Yeah, check this. Oh, fat one. Is that top 10 position again? Yeah, that's 7-8 kilograms, this striped bass. No, it's a steelhead. Whoa. Check 5.3. Okay, it's going really well, really well. Because at the moment I think that it's a unique steelhead time zone 2. So it's not bad, it's not bad. It goes really well, to be honest. 10 kilogram behind the first one and 5 kilogram behind the second one. So it's not bad. I'm very happy to go blindly into the competition. And now I need to watch it a little bit, because now I got the feeling that the spot is drying up at the moment. So I'm not sure. Most of the time that's a feeling, because that's something that you never can have. So a lot of guys, I see it on the forums too, they ask how do people win the whole time and all that stuff. It's not only knowledge, it's not only RNG, but at some point you got the feeling, oh, this spot is dry. You got that feeling, and on that moment, you switch. It sounds very strange, but you need, that's a feeling. You cannot explain it. You cannot say you need to catch 5 fish or 6 fish on that spot and then it's done. No, you cannot say that. You need to feel it. And I got now that feeling. But the main problem is that after this spot, I know another spot here at the right. I need to be very lucky that that spot is active. So I'm going to do 1 or 2 more tries. Then I go for 5 minutes to the right dock. Because you guys can see the first one got now another fish too. But he's not catching the fish at the same rate anymore. Because he was stuck at 29 kilograms for some time. So that means his spot is now going down too. And you guys can see it, I don't have a traction anymore on the lure. No. So that's a pity. I was hoping for 1 or 2 fish more. Then I was top 10 to go in the trophy Chinook time zone. Okay, what we are going to do now is, let's switch. Okay. Oh shit, I just, yeah, that's a problem, AZERTY keyboard. So by accident I just put like the medium spoon on. So now I need to switch again. I hope it's not that far, the walker. Yeah, here it is. Okay, so this is a good position too. So just straight on. I think even that you can get here the unique steelhead. So let's have a look that we can get a couple of striped bass, like 2 or 3. But we need to be very quick. So I'm not sure this position. Yeah, this position. Like I said to you guys, it's a feeling. And you know, I didn't even guess for it. So, but this one is small. He's very small. I don't think he's 5 kilogram. Yeah, he's always even. Ooh, 7. Check trophy steelhead trout. Okay. Come to daddy. Come to daddy. Beautiful fish. Okay. And I'm now number 4. And everybody is now saying, what the fuck? What the fuck? What is he doing? What is he doing? They will see it in this video, what I'm doing. So the switching was a very good move. And if I can, yeah, another one. Because this is a smallmouth bass. You can see it right away on the tension on the right. Okay, let's release this fellow. And by the way, you don't need to throw that far here. So the thing is, you can see it. I think that 30 meters is even more than enough. You don't need to throw 40 meters with it. Come on, give me one more fish. 5-6 kilograms. Because I only got like 3 minutes left. Maybe another steelhead. Maybe the unique steelhead. That would be so cool. Because I never got this fish. I never tried to get him. Yeah, there. Come on, fishy. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Good. Oh, it's a small... Oh. No, it's a good one. Haha, check this, guys. Almost number 1. So it's going... Those topwater lures, they are so insane good. It's beautiful. Do you know what I said, guys? First hour, 20 to 30 kilograms is good. I'm now at 38 kilograms. Still 2 minutes to go. And I think this spot is not dry yet. So I got only two fish on this spot. So let's have a look that we can lure one or two more fish. Come on, RNG. Be my friend. Yeah, there is a fish. Come on. Oh, he strike, but he missed. I think it was a smallmouth bass. That's a pity. That's a pity. So, yeah. And the first one got 45 kilograms already. Okay. 1 minute to go. So that means one or two casts more. Yeah, and you know, the thing is, now I can get very excited and think, whoa, it's going to happen, but it's not. No. This is a good start. Why is this a good start? Because I got a lot of fish. I got nice amount of kilograms. But the main problem is, this is not going to make me win this competition. For the simple reason that, yeah, it's still trophy Chinook time, RNG. You can get a Chinook trophy that is 12 kilograms, or you can get one that is 20 kilograms. That means you got, like, with that Chinook, one striped bass more. And then we start on the unique striped bass. If I don't get the unique striped bass, because I never got the unique striped bass with the Walker, yeah, I'm fucked, because the guys that are going to be top 10, they got one, two striped bass, for sure. I once saw a guy here, and that guy, he got three unique striped bass, and all above 15 kilograms. So he had around 40 kilograms of fish with only three fish. So that was so crazy. It was unbelievable. And that guy didn't even win the comp. Oh, yeah. Steelhead, small one, no striped bass. Oh, it's a good one. 6 kilograms. I don't know what the problem is, but it's very strange at the moment. But in the past, my tension was a lot higher with fish like from this size, sorry. Because now I cannot see it. I thought once again it was 4-5 kilogram fish, but it's always nicely 6-7 kilogram fish, so it's not bad. And guys, it's now oh another fish, come on. Yeah, check this. What the fuck, man? Oh. Yeah, it's unbelievable how much fish that I catch. I'm now number one. Okay, guys, 7 a.m. So it's time to switch to the dam. So now we are going to try to get a trophy Chinook. So it's now 7 o'clock. So here at the right is a good spot. And that's where we are going to throw. So I'm very amazed. I can say there is already a guy that got even the trophy Chinook, I think. It's a possibility it's a trophy striped bass too. But I don't think it's trophy striped bass time zone. So he was very lucky that he got a trophy outside the time zones. So now we need to have luck. So I got 50 kilogram of fish. It's unbelievable. I was expecting very good bite ratio, but I was not expecting this, to be honest. 50 kilograms in like 50 minutes real life fishing. So, but now we need to have the Chinook. So I need to have around 80, 90 kilograms of fish if we go to the next hour. We are going back to the old spot that we were just fishing, because we are going to try at 8 a.m. to get, yeah, that's a good fish. I think that's already a Chinook. And the beauty about Chinooks is I don't think that they go under 5 kilograms. Don't say this is a trophy. It cannot be possible, no. Imagine that for the video, that I'm going to do a perfect run. No, it's a small one. But yeah, still, I'm still number one. It's unbelievable. Yeah, by the way, you guys can think now, yeah, that Shamino, he was practicing the whole day. No, it's just, I thought about the concept that I wanted to do, like a little bit gameplay, going blind with the topwater lures. But yeah, I'm just freelancing at the moment, so maybe the game thinks, okay, he needs a little bit of RNG. But yeah, I'm not going to jinx it that much, because I know competitions are very unforgiving. It's a possibility that it stops now for me and that I get 100 kilogram fish and that I'm like 50 or 60 placed in this competition. So let's keep going, let's keep the focus up. And let's keep throwing at this position. Why did I start on this position? For the simple reason that on the other position, I never got the trophy Chinook. So I'm not sure how that comes. Maybe it's too deep, because here it's shallow water. So it's not that deep, maybe 1 meter. Yeah, check this. But that I know. I know the Chinook loves the Walker. And no, it's not a trophy. I don't hope this is a trophy. Yeah, it looks like a big fish. Oh, don't. You need to fight a little bit more, because otherwise it's not. Yeah, 16 kilograms. What the fuck, man? What is happening here in this game? Oh, that's so good. I'm going to drink, guys, because I'm not sure what is happening at the moment. But it's just crazy. And I know after this video, if it keeps going like this, I think that everybody is going to fish with the Walker. It's just going to be like that, to be honest. I got almost 30 kilograms fish more than the second one. Yeah, this is a smallmouth bass. So it's crazy. It's just crazy. And you can see in the there are still some guys that keep going for the striped bass. That's not a good plan. So, because you guys can see, I got now 16 kilogram fish. And you never can get the 60 kilogram fish if you keep going for the striped bass. But I'm not sure what I need to do now. I can keep going on this position, or I can switch to the other position. Because I don't think I can get two trophies on that position. But if you go to the left position, you can... Oh, another bite? Yeah, another Chinook. Fuck my life, man. What is happening? Yeah, 80 kilograms. Oh boy. Yeah. It's going well. It's video RNG, I think. Yeah, it's going very, very crazy at the moment. So, this scenario, yeah. I cannot write it before I make the video, to be honest. I was hoping that I got a little bit attraction. But this is like crazy. 80 kilograms of fish. I got now 31 kilograms more than the second one. And you guys saw it live in the video. So it's not that it's the first time that I do it with the topwater lures. So maybe the topwater lures are so good compared to the other lures. Because I know a lot of guys are fishing here with the crankbait. Oh, oh fuck. Did you guys see the Chinook? He was in front of me. Ah, fuck my life. So let's switch now to the other position and let's have a look what we can get there. But still, it's not over. Because the unique striped bass time zone still comes into play between 8 and 10 a.m. So, yeah, and I got... No, it's just the lure that is making that circle. I thought there was already a fish coming behind my lure. But on this position, I'm not going to try that long for the simple reason what I just told you guys. I never got even a Chinook on that position with this lure. So, if I don't got attraction, I'm just going to switch back to the right position. Yeah, and the problem is, I think that those guys, they switched to the float maybe. That's a possibility, because normally I go with the floater here too, between 7 and 8 shiners, 4-0 hook, I think 140 centimeter on this position, so. Yeah, it's very strange, that position. I know there is Chinook. If I put a crankbait on, the 3.5 meter or the 2.5 meter, I get a Chinook. But with the Walker, it doesn't work. Don't ask me why. It's very strange. Because if I get now another trophy, yeah, it's a perfect game, you know. Perfect game, 20, 30 kilograms first hour, and then the next hour two trophies, left and right. So you need to switch. Yeah, but I don't think this spot is so good for topwater. That's the third cast, no attraction. And this spot has to be active, very active. Because I didn't fish on that spot. It's trophy time zone. I know there is Chinook. So what we are going to do now, guys... Oh, This is a smallmouth bass, yeah. I know. That's a pity. So we are going to switch back to the right one. So normally... Oh, what the fuck did I switch? Ah, once again, yeah. You guys know it's Azerty, so... And I push Z, sit, to go yeah, more to the front. But I'm amazed that after 7 minutes into the trophy Chinook time zone, that there is nobody that got a Chinook trophy. Maybe that 13 kilogram one guy. Ah, there is another one. Okay. The zoo guy, he got now another one too. So he had probably a striped trophy, 13 kilograms. And now he got the Chinook 16 kilograms. He got such a good RNG at the moment. It's unbelievable. But I hope that I can get a couple of more Chinooks, because yeah, you guys can see it now, it's a little bit dead. So this is a dead problem. I can go for the striped bass position and hope that I can get a couple of striped bass, but I want to get another trophy. So what I needed to do now is I need to switch to the floater. But I want to do it with the top water lures entire competition. So if I go now with the floater to the left position, I'm going to get, if I'm very lucky, oh yeah, another one. Smallmouth bass. No, it is a Chinook. Yeah, 7 kilograms, okay. Yeah, excuse me, I'm not going to talk about luck, because yeah, you guys can check it out yourself. So, what is it? It's now 18 kilograms more than the second one. So it's not going that bad for me, but I want 100 kilograms in the half of the competition. But they keep biting the Chinook. I don't see this position drying up at the moment, so let's hope one or two more. It's a possibility I don't get any more fish now. But the problem is that they come all the way, they follow all the way until they are in front of me. So, but like I always said, if I don't have water anymore, I cannot do a presentation. That's how it works. So, and that's problematic with the walker, because at some point it comes out of the water, and that's how it is. Because I don't think that the fish bites on if the walker is still. Yeah, there is another fish. Yeah, check this. What the hell, man? They are so good. Yeah, the topwater lures, it's crazy, it's really crazy, it's unbelievable. 93 kilograms of fish. This was a close one, 5.8. But if you check, I got almost 40 kilograms more than position number 10 at the moment. But yeah, that doesn't mean anything, because not everybody start at the same time, so there are a lot of guys that start a little bit later. So 18 minutes in game, and then we are going to switch to the striped bass position. Position from the start, so on the dock. Yeah, it's crazy. Crazy fishing. Really crazy fishing, unbelievable. Yeah, I'm very happy, to be honest, because everything works as I planned, so that's not bad. Come on, give me one more Chinook in the next 3 minutes, please, game. That I got 100 kilogram, that's a nice marker in the half of the competition. Because I got that feeling again. The feeling that the spot is dry. I got it like the first hour, I got the same feeling. So now I need to switch, but I don't want to switch that soon to the unique striped bass. Because in my head, something is saying if I go to that position a little bit too soon and it's dry before the unique striped bass time starts, I'm going to get fucked, you know. Because I cannot do anything about it. I need to wait, sit it out. So, yeah, there is a fish. Oh, he missed. Oh, why? Yeah, that guy is fishing with the floater. I can understand it. I'm not fishing with floaters anymore. Oh, check this. Smallmouth bass in competitions because you got too much bait is lost and all that shit. So, and you cannot miss fish, to be honest. It's the main problem is if you go for the trophy Chinook and you miss your trophy Chinook, yeah, you're fucked, you know. That's 16 kilograms that you miss. Simple like that. So if I can yeah, skip it, I'm going to skip float fishing in a competition. But sometimes it's so good to float fishing, and sometimes you cannot do anything else because you need to float fish. So, but that's the same for everybody. So, and 1 minute to go, guys. So, and you guys already see it. Number two and number three are going very, very close. So that's a problem. I needed to switch to the floater too, and I was already a little bit higher. But you guys see it now. It's getting smaller and smaller. So the difference is not that big anymore. And those two guys, I know them. They are doing very well always in this competition. I know that. Because I try to figure out what they are doing. I don't think that they are doing. Yeah, there is a fish. Come on. Yeah, come on. Ah, not a smallmouth bass. Fuck my life. Shit game. It's always the same. I'm going to rage on the forums. Damn game. Damn, why? Okay, one more cast, and then we are going to switch to the other position. Yeah, and you guys already see it. So that guy just jumped over me. That's how it is. So I had a brief moment of fame, but now my fame is already gone. That's how it goes in competition. But the thing is, you never can panic. That's the problem. I see it a lot with guys too. They panic and they start thinking, what the fuck, it's not going to happen. No, this spot is just dry. I just said what the problem was, so I cannot do a lot about it. So you can think there is something magic that I need to do, and there is a fish. Come on, bite. Come on, give me a trophy. Give me fucking a trophy. Do it. No, it's a fat Chinook. Yeah, I think I'm going to be place number one, and now it's unique striped bass time zone. Yeah, there you go, 99 kilograms. Okay, lads, time to switch. So 8 o'clock. I hope this spot is now active because in the past it was never active for me. So I don't know what I need to do otherwise. Normally I go now with large cut bait on the position that I was just in front of me, 25 meters. So I hope this spot is active, because if this spot is not active the next 30 minutes, I'm not going to catch one fish. That's what going to happen. So, but I know the first 2 hours were perfect. So the walker worked really well the first 2 hours. But now, yeah, it can be problematic because I don't think this is so good, this spot. So, but we need to wait. Let's have a look how it goes. And that's already not bad, but I think it's a smallmouth bass. No, it's a largemouth bass. So let's release this fellow. So now we need to check out what it's going to bring, because I cannot switch to the other position because it's way too deep over there. So let's hope, because now it's unique striped bass zone. And if you come here and the fish is not biting as it bites at the moment, I'm already worried. Do you guys see it? Smallmouth bass attraction, but that's it. So that's cast number two. So I hope this spot is becoming active. Otherwise, I'm fucked. That's how it is. So, and I'm not going to switch it because my goal was go blindly with topwater lures. I'm not going to switch it. I just keep it like this because I know what I can do now to do it better. But I need to go with the floater, and I'm not going to do that. I want to do this competition entirely with my walker. And you guys see it, there is no attraction. So it's not a good sign at the moment. No. Yeah, it's a pity. But I don't think that the other guys are getting fish either, so that's always good. So if nobody is getting fish, yeah, that's always good too, you know. Maybe we need to switch a little bit to the right again. Because you can get, yeah, that's a fish. Come on. Unique, come on, give me the unique. Right away, unique in the pocket. Give me the RNG, man. 7 kilograms? Yeah, give me 7 kilograms. 100 kilogram of fish already. Oh, it's a steelhead. Yeah, that's good, 6 kilograms. That's, oh no, it's a striped bass. Okay, so the striped bass is here. They are active. Yeah, I cannot say that really at the moment because it's only my first fish. But okay, it's not a bad sign. That's what I can say. So if they bite, it's okay. Yeah, another fish. There is another one. Yeah, it's active. I'm going to win this competition so hard now. Oh, but this is a very small one. Is this a steelhead? Yeah. 5, come on. No, I'm fucked. It's a small one. 4.8. I'm going to keep this fellow because I like this trout. Ah, that's a pity. So that's a little bit RNG too, guys. So if this was a 5 kilogram one, I had already 110. But I think for the other guys, it's just the same story at the moment. It seems it's not. I'm not sure with what they are fishing at the moment. Maybe they are fishing with the topwater lures too. That's always a possibility. But or maybe it's just not unique striped bass time zone. That's a possibility too. But I think so. From 8 to 10. Yeah, come on, fishy. Come on. Yeah, come to daddy. Oh, a small one again. Oh no, it's 6 kilogram. Okay. 5.7. Lucky shot, lucky shot. And you know what is so fun about this competition? You know, the more fish that you are catching, the harder other people are going, yeah, to get close to you. So that's good because I know 170, 180 kilograms of fish, most of the time that's top 10. So I only need now 50 kilograms of fish. So if I get now, and there is another fish, I think that the spot is becoming very active at the moment. But he didn't bite. But that's a possibility. That's the case with topwater lure fishing. Maybe it's so good. I already said it in some of my other videos. Maybe it's so good that you need to calculate always those fake bites in it. Oh, that was a bad retrieve. What the hell am I doing? I need to keep the focus up because the second guy is only 1 kilogram behind me. And where is the unique striped bass? Jesus Christ, come on, game. 18 kilogram, 20 kilogram. Or maybe a trophy striped bass. I'm already happy with that too. Oh, what is this? Oh, smallmouth bass. Yeah, I saw him coming to the surface. Oh no, it's a largemouth bass. Okay, let's throw him back in the water. 23 minutes to go, guys. 23 minutes to go. And it's still going very well. So, it's not going bad. So, still position number one. Steady in the top 10. That's always good. But this spot is not active at all. You guys can see it. Maybe it's from 9 to 10 a little bit better. If I remember, I think it was very good from 9 to 10. Maybe this is like a unique time zone too, but like not a very good unique. Yeah, it sounds really crazy, but you can get unique here too, maybe, but not a lot of other fish. That's a possibility too. But everybody is going now for the striped bass. I see it in the chat. And it's not that other guys are catching like 30, 40 kilograms of fish already in this time zone, so. We just need, yeah. Oh, what the fuck? Did I miss that fish? Ah, damn it. It was just a good strike. It was on, yeah, come on. Oh, what is happening, man? I'm getting nervous. That's what's happening. Yeah, that's a good fish. No, smallmouth bass. What the fuck? Yeah, there is a guy that got a unique. 90 kilograms. He's not even in the top 10, but he got a unique. So the unique is here. It's a unique time zone. So 19 kilograms, so that's a very big fish. Yeah, and I'm now second. Because I don't know that I can get unique with this setup, with this lure. It's a possibility I cannot get unique, so. And then I'm going to lose the competition. That second guy, that zoo guy, he got a unique striped bass too because his Chinook was 16 kilograms. Yeah, what the fuck is this with the largemouth bass? You guys can see it? That's what can happen. So now at the moment, I cannot do a lot about it. I just need to sit it out. Everybody is jumping over my head. So I cannot do a lot about it. Maybe it's the lure, maybe it's the position. Maybe I need to switch to the other position. But I think this is a unique striped bass position, so I'm not sure. I think it's the maybe the lure is the problem. Because I got one striped bass and that's all. So and a steelhead from 4.8 kilogram. So that's not so much at this position. Yeah, that first guy he got a striped bass unique and was 19 kilograms. Come on, game, give me a trophy or a unique. Come on, and I'm back at number one. So I'm going to keep trying on this position. So I cannot do a lot. I need to sit it out at the moment. No, it's a smallmouth bass again. Or is it a small one? Ah, fuck. Yes, 4.5. So that's a pity. That's a pity. Most of the time, that's not a good sign. If you get a fish that is that small and it's unique time zone, most of the time, yeah, this position is not so active and not so good. Now it's already 10 kilograms behind on the first one. So it can go really quick if you start catching fish that is 19 to 20 kilograms. But I'm not going to switch, I stay here. Maybe I can throw a little bit over there because that's you can get unique over there too. But it's a possibility those guys are fishing with the floater at the moment. I'm not sure. Yeah, you guys see it now. It goes really quick. So I was so much in front when we started this hour. And now you need to check it. Oh. Ah, too small once again. Jesus Christ. Ah, boy. Okay, let's try over there again. Yeah, like I said, you can fish 2 hours very good. And then all of a sudden, if you don't catch any more fish, it's game over. So, come on, fishy. Bite, please. Yeah. Be a trophy striped bass. It's a fat fish. I hope. Yeah, okay. We are back in business, guys. Okay, good. So, you need to imagine now that I had like those two or three fish that were just under 5 kilograms. You need to imagine that they were 5 kilograms. I was still second position. I got 128 kilograms. But the thing is, I got the feeling that I cannot win it at the moment because those guys, the last hour you will see it, they are going to catch around 40, 50 kilograms more fish. And I don't think that I'm going to do that. Or this spot need to become so active, or I need to get the unique striped bass. Oh, come on. Steelhead, bite. Yes, bite. And give me points. It's a striped bass, by the way. Okay, we are back in business, guys. We are back in business. So, as I already said, like I think 30 minutes ago. So the thing is, you guys saw it. I had a dead zone. I had a long dead zone. It was 10 minutes that it was so dead. On that moment, a lot of guys, they start switching lures. They start switching positions. Yeah, there is another fish. Come on. Oh, fuck. He missed it. That was a unique. Yes, that was a unique. I'm sure of it. So they start switching positions. So what did I do? I just sit it out. I know this is the position. So you cannot do a lot about it. There is another position at the right here. You can do that. Or you can maybe go with the floater to the dam. But at some point, yeah, you need to take a decision. And I'm still, yeah, position 4. So that's not bad. Because those guys that are in front of me, I know them. Not personally, but they are very good competition fishers. So, yeah, and there is another one. Oh, what is this? Largemouth bass again. I need to say that the smallmouth bass and largemouth bass, they bite really well. But it's still going very well without any preparation with the top water. So I'm very happy with the position 4, you know. It's not bad. Those guys, they know what they are doing. It's not that they are all like doing this the first time. The most of those guys, they got probably 500-600 competitions already, so. Come on, unique striped bass. Come to daddy, I need you. Around 20 kilograms and then a couple of more. Because I'm now 13 kilograms behind. But you guys can see it, all those guys, they got the unique striped bass. So, because I don't think they got it's the trophy Chinook. I don't think so. I think they got trophy Chinook and they got like the unique striped bass. But they are not catching an insane amount of fish because I think we started around 100 kilograms. Yeah, it's not bad, of course. No, what I'm saying now, they got like 40 kilograms of fish this hour. I got 25 kilograms of fish. Yeah, there is another one. 23 kilogram unique striped bass. Fuck my life. Unbelievable, that fish. That's, I think, going to be the biggest one that they are going to catch in this competition. Ah, the fish is becoming active. Ah, okay. Because I see now fish jumping out of the water. That's the first time that I see that. So that means that the fish is becoming active. Very active. Yeah. Look how much bites that I got at the moment. Come on, fishy. The last 14 minutes. So I think top 10 is going to be very difficult for me. I already know that. Because I think the first two guys, they are gone. I cannot compete anymore with him because I don't have a unique this hour, so that's done. And I'm not even sure that I need to stay on this position. So, the top water lures were very good at the first 2 hours, I need to say, but very good. But the next time that I'm going to do this competition, I'm going to switch at the unique striped bass hour to something else. And this guy got his second unique, I think. If I'm not mistaken, so. Thirteen minutes to go. Come on, unique striped bass, come to daddy. Yeah, that's a fish. Ah, don't say to me it's a small one again. Oh boy, yeah. Smallmouth bass again. And the first guy already got 152 kilograms. So I told you guys, it's around 200 kilograms that you need to have. And they will get to it. Because they still got 1 hour. And this hour is going to be the best, I think, from the entire competition. So if they are lucky, they get like one unique striped bass more. But I need to figure out, oh, there, fish. Is it a small? Don't say it's a small one again. Jesus Christ. Oh no, 5 kilograms. Okay. Money fish, money fish. So I'm still top 10, you know, 12 minutes to go. So yeah, let's hope for one biggie. Do I got attraction? No, I thought that I saw a fish coming behind my lure. Yeah, that's a fish. Okay. Striped bass. Is it a good one? Give me 7 kilograms, please. Yeah, 6 kilograms is good too. Position 7. Okay, we are back in business, guys. If the game throws me now a unique of 20 kilograms, I'm at position 1. So there is a possibility that, yeah, you never know, you never know. You always need to keep believing in yourself in a competition. That's very important, and don't get stressed. That's very important too. Yeah, another one, come on, come to, yeah, nice. Steelhead, small one. Yeah, too small. Really game? Really? 4.99999. Yeah, the game is trolling me. That's what is happening at the moment. But I see a pattern that it's becoming very active at the moment. You guys can see it. Every guest I got a fish now. But the problem is it's not the right fish. I don't want steelheads. I want the unique striped bass. So everybody is getting trophy. Check those guys. Trophy striped bass, trophy striped bass. They're all getting trophy striped bass and I'm not getting striped bass. So, yeah. Maybe it's a topwater lure. I don't know. It's a possibility that the striped bass is going a little bit deeper or something. That's always possible. But I would kill now for a trophy striped bass, to be honest. Come on, come to daddy. Yeah, but they are not active at all, the striped bass. There is no attraction at the moment on my lure. So, yeah, that's always a sign that you know, okay, it's, yeah. But after all, it's only 10 more minutes to go, so I did not bet with the top water lures. Oh, yeah, yeah, oh. Oh, what do we get? Come on. Let my drag click, yeah, go baby, come on, do it. Oh, this is a steelhead, what the fuck, I don't want steelhead. I think that the steelheads like the walker a lot too, to be honest. And I don't think this is the right position that I need to fish for the striped bass. I think all those guys are just on the dam with the floater at the moment. Because that's what I do in the past two in competitions on a sunny day. I was thinking, okay, I saw that fish striking, I saw him getting my drag loose, but it was a steelhead. Yeah, and there I go, out of the top 10. So, yep, told you guys it. And still 9 minutes to go, so it's a pity. But let's try to get a couple of more fish. I got now 140 kilograms. So if I can get 150, 160, I'm going to be happy. So it was not bad fishing. The first 2 hours I was on the first place. So that's not bad. Maybe I need to throw a little bit more to the right. Like straight on the activity on the water. Maybe that's where I need to be. Yeah, I'm going to do that. Throw a little bit more to the right. Maybe I have a little bit more luck on that position. Okay, let's switch. Let's throw over over there. And let's have a look that we can get the fish over there. Come on, striped bass. Come on. Come to daddy. You can do it. Just give me one unique for the end of the video. I don't think it's going to happen, guys. I don't think it's going to happen. Position 12 still. So, yeah. It's a pity, because it was going really well. But yeah, I need to say, the second dude, he got at the moment Yeah, 20 kilograms fish more than I got. I think this lure is not so good for trophy and unique striped bass. That's the main problem. I think it's very good to catch a lot of small fish, like normal fish. And steelhead too, I need to say. But for the striped bass, it's not that great. There is a fish. Yeah. Come on, more than five. No, it's a steelhead again. And I think it's more than five. Yeah, five. Okay, thank you. So it's only steelhead here at the moment. The striped bass fish that I got, I think they were just lucky shots. So. Oh, another one. Oh, activity. No, smallmouth bass again. No, no, no. Oh, 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 oh. Striped bass again. Here we go. Hopla. 8th position. Oh, cool. And those guys, they are just getting unique striped bass the whole time in the chat. And I'm at position 10 at the moment. 8, sorry, 8. So it's not bad fishing. It's not bad fishing. I'm very happy that I made this amount of fish. Maybe I can get a couple of more. Because it's now very active, the spot. Come on, give me now the unique. And then I'm top 3 again. I only need 15 kilograms to be the third. I think the position 1 is gone. That guy is so good at this competition. It's unbelievable how good he is. Okay, let's go again. Let's go really quick. Come on, trophy striped bass game. Or unique striped bass, please. Give it to me. Give it to me. Yeah, the first guy, he got now his second unique. So, unique striped bass. He got 215 kilograms of fish. So, you can get a lot of fish here in 1 hour real life fishing. I think it was just a brief moment that it was active. Because now it's done. Come on, fishy. 5 more minutes, guys. Come on. Most of the time, at the end of a competition, most of the time you get like a very large fish. So I'm not sure. I guess that's in the program or something. But I got it already so many times in competitions. But now I need a very large fish to keep myself in the top 10. Yeah, that's not a big fish, this one. Just a largemouth bass, I think, again. Yes, let's keep him, because I want to get a full net. Yeah, the pity is, it's a pity, it's a pity. It's, yeah. One trophy striped bass, one unique striped bass, and our second position. That's how it is. So I need to figure out, can I get a unique striped bass? Because I fished already here, like for my video with this setup. And I never got a unique striped bass. I got a trophy, I think. But a unique I never got. So I'm not sure that I can get it with this setup. Three more minutes just before the competition stops. I can just check my net for one brief moment. Just have a look how many fish that I got, how much money that I made, because it's nice money too if you got that amount of fish. You know what I'm going to do? Or not? No, I'm going to stay here. Maybe I can switch really quick to the other position. Because you can get the unique over there too. Okay. For the last 3 minutes. Maybe I'm lucky. You never know. Maybe I'm lucky. I need a little bit of luck now. Okay. 2 more minutes on this position. And let's get going. Let's get going. That there is a little bit of attraction still for the walker. No, this is dead too. It's not going to happen, guys. It's very dead. Because you can get the striped bass here too. But it all depends on the uniques. Because those guys at the top, you need to imagine if I got two unique striped bass more, that's 40 kilograms. So that's position two. So that was the difference. In competition, you always need to know what is the difference. Most of the time, you always can think, yeah, okay, they got that kind of fish more than I got. Oh, come on. Oh, he missed. Ah, pity. No, he striked. Oh, is it a small one again? Yeah. No. Is it a good fish? Yeah, it's a good fish. 160 kilograms. So the striped bass is sitting here. Yeah, 5.5. I take that one. Okay, last cast, one more. Give me top 10. Come on. Yeah, I'm super focused now. Super focused. 1 minute to go. Come on. Come on, one more of 7 kilograms. Come on. That means that I got 100 kilograms the first 2 hours and around 60 kilograms the second 2 hours. So the first 2 hours were the best for me. So I need to find a solution for the last 2 hours. It's possible it was just RNG, I don't know, but I think it's the lure. I think it's not so good for the unique. I think there are better lures that you can use for the unique or float fishing. I think that's the problem too. Okay, we can maybe do one more cast, but now I need to do a cast that is very short. So let's have a look first, guys, to the fish keeper. So 26,000 currency. I got a lot of steel head trout. You guys can see it. A lot of striped bass. Yeah, not a lot. Yeah, a decent amount of striped bass. A trophy chinook. That's not bad. So it went really well. I think 160 kilogram is not bad to just go blind in a competition. So I'm not sure. I think I'm going to be around, let's say, position 30, 40 maybe, because a lot of guys are going to jump over me. I know that. I needed to have 170 for sure to be top 20. So it was a good competition. So that was it for the video, guys. I'm going to check really quick the results. So that's not bad. 26,000 currency. So let's have a look to events rankings. So 31 people finished, and you guys can see it here. So they all got like the unique striped bass. I didn't get that fish. That was my major problem. If I get the unique, I was around here with Tommy, 180 kilograms. So that was it for the video, guys. A little bit of a guide blindly with topwater fishing into a contest. It went really well. It went better than I expected. If you like the video, give me a like. If you like my channel, subscribe, please. Thanks for watching. Have fun in Extravaganza in California. And I see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.